Pasó bien. Que no. On the cold sniper. That'd be a nice one. My first of the morning. Been here, what, 5-10 minutes? Gosh. This thing will mash up your hands. Not bad, huh? Nice little 3-pounder right here.
Episode of Bassin' West Coast. Cringy enough? Alright, no, everybody, hope you guys are having a good Thursday. It's Thursday. I'm fishing here during the week. I can't fish this weekend, and my job got canceled for the day. It might even get canceled tomorrow because of the rain. It's beautiful out here today. Little few clouds here and there. It's sunny. It's hot. It's actually hot. I'm actually hot with what I'm wearing right now. I'm gonna take off my sweater in a minute or two. But I'm out here at Isers Reef targeting sand bass. I was gonna go out to Lake Paris, but it was gonna be a struggle to dry my boat after I took off the tarp. It was pretty wet, so that plan got scratched. It was also probably not a good idea to go to Lake Paris with this cold front that just came in. I mean, that cold front is just gonna push those bass way back. You know, when the cold front slides and comes through Paris, those bass hit the cover. I mean, out deep, those bass are very delicate. Don't know why, don't ask me. Anyway, so yeah, I'm out here at Isers. Checking out a few spots. I was idling around this morning for a little while, maybe a good 10-15 minutes. Kill the motor. Yeah, I was out here a good 10-15 minutes. Control the motor on, make sure it's working. There it goes. Anyways, I was out here this morning idling around, and I found this area of really good structure. Had a lot of, I mean, this area is big. Everybody knows Isers is pretty big, but this area that I was idling around in, a lot of structure, a lot of bait fish and bass. And what I did is I used my side imaging to target that air, to set a boundary for me. You know, 100 feet, just waypoint, just make a circle. I wanted to fish that area because, I mean, that's where I found pretty good stuff. Just gonna get set up right here. Anyways, this morning was a really good morning. I was out here using a cold sniper. I saw a ton of bait fish. I was using the 100 gram cold sniper but I lost it a minute ago. I think lobster, one of the ropes, the buoys, the nets, whatever you want to call those. I don't do that type of fishing. I think I got caught up and I couldn't get it out. Anyways, I've been using the Colt Sniper and it's been working really good for me this morning. I say there's a lot of bait fish down here, so that's why I busted this thing out. And I'm using it on my medium heavy rod. It's actually a medium. It's rated 20, 30 pound test. It's rated like medium heavy, medium, you want to call it. It's a good jig rod. It's 8 foot rod. I'm using a Lexa 400, 65 pound braid on a 30 pound fluorocarbon leader. 4 or 5 feet, that's all you really need. You don't really need much. When you let this thing fall back down, you want to make sure you let it fall all the way back down to the bottom, because that's where the bass are going. Those bass are on the bottom or suspended 5-10 feet. That's it. He's a good one. Yeah, baby. Bam, that's how it's done. Look at this beast. Oh my gosh. Oh my gosh. Thing's a giant. Jeez. Oh my god. This dog is so freaking strong. I mean, these guys are strong as it is already. This is about a 5-pounder right here. 5.5. Oh, pushing 6. Check it out. This is a monster right here. Damn. That's 24 inches. So I'd say, yeah, looking at 5 pushing 6. 5.5 pushing 6 right here. PB for me, pretty badass to get him on that Colt Sniper.
here you go.
Get yourself a couple Colt snipers. Come to Isers. Get out here and have some fun. I don't even remember if I caught that guy on the fall or on the jig. I guess we'll see the video later.
I went for the net so fast. I saw that he was barely hit. I'm gonna show you guys. Oh, check that out. See how easy this is gonna come off. Boom. Another good one. 3.5 pounds right here.
Anything. I had oatmeal on the way here and 2 bananas. That's about it. And a coffee. Anyways, like the video. Give it a like. Don't forget to subscribe. We'll be doing some calico trips in the next 2-3 weeks, as well as freshwater fishing. Weapon of choice, that Colt Sniper. I mean, get out here and do it. You're gonna have to put in work, don't get me wrong, you know, but I mean, it pays off. That was a good bag right there. That was at least 16 pounds, 17 pounds, pushing 18, maybe. I didn't get that big, that fifth fish that I wanted, keeper. Oh well, you know, I want to get out of here early. I'm gonna catch that traffic. Bananas, I bring them out all the time, so it never affects us. But anyways, hope you guys like the video again. Thanks for watching. See you guys soon back out on the water. If you guys ever see me out here, say what's up. Peace.